Welcome to this second lecture. In today's lecture, we'll see current divider and voltage divider. Okay, so what is concept, how the current divides in a circuit and how the voltage divides, or you can say a concept of parallel and series circuit, which you may have seen in your earlier classes also, but for the sake of continuity, we'll do it. Then we'll also see the practical application of this simple voltage divider, where it is used and how it is important. So voltage divider being a very, very basic, but it's not a trivial thing. It is useful and it is a practical one. Then we'll also see the mesh analysis, how to write KVL equations, and how to write those equations KVL and explain them with the example, and we'll see how to write those circuit equations. So first things first, that is basically what is the I can say current division. So let us see current division here it means that if you have a current source having a value having a current value of I, and then if you have resistances, say R1, R2 and R3, then there is a flow of current in this circuit. So there is a flow, say a current I1 would flow in R1, a current I2 would flow in R2, and current I3 would flow in R3, and some of these three currents would be equal to I. So first thing is this I1 plus I2 plus I3 would sum up to give you the value of I, total I. So that is how, that is what is divided among the three resistances. And this division of current in the resistance is inverse proportion to the value of resistance. That means if you have a high resistance, a smaller current would like to flow, and if you have a lower resistance, a higher current would flow. Okay, and also if you see these three points, they are essentially the same points. All these three are same potential, so the potential there is same. So the potential of this point and this point is same. So you can say that I1 into R1, which is potential across R1, should be equal to I2 into R2, that is potential across R2, okay, and that should be equal to I3 R3. So these three rules, with these three rules, you can write this equation, that is I1, if you see, I1 will be equal to V1 by R1 or V by R1, and I2 would be equal to V by R2, and similarly I3 will be equal to V by R3. These are the three currents that can be there, and if I try to put this equation, then what do you get? You can write this as total current, that is total current is I, and that I can be calculated as I1 plus I2 plus I3, and this equation can be further written as V by R2 plus V by R3. That is the total amount of current in this. And from this, obviously, you can just do some simplification. That is how it is divided. And from this, I can write that is V by I is equal to R1 V by I, sorry, it's not I1. V by I is equal to R1 at R1 R2 R3 upon R1 plus R1 R2, that is all combination, remaining combinations R2 R3 R3 and R1. This is given though for only three resistances, but simple formula is that what you do is, if you have three resistance, then take all the combinations in two, R1, R2 and so on. If they are three, and if they are four, then obviously it will be combinations of three and so on. So that is what V by I is. And from this, if I want to calculate, say, I1, then I can calculate it as R2 R3 upon R1 R2 plus R2 R3 . So that is what, if you want to similarly calculate I2, you can calculate in a similar fashion. What will be I2? That will be in 2, so remaining will depend on R1, R3 upon, if I say this is sum of R, this part is sum of R, and a combination and sum of R, combinations of R, then I can write it as this. So this is basically current division rule, and you can also say the three resistances are connected in parallel, and that is how the current divides in them. Okay, so how the current I1, I2 and I3 can be calculated, you can use these formulas or a generalization of this formula. Now let us see about a similar thing like voltage division. So in a voltage division, that is a network explaining voltage division, here we have a voltage source, supplying V, and let's say here also there are three resistances, they are connected like this. And as you see, if all these three are said to be in the same circuit and they are one after the other, so they are called as, the resistances are connected in series, and the seriesness or series can be understood that there is only one current flowing through it. So this, all three are in series because a current I1 flows through it, same current I1 flows through it. And if I call this as V1, voltage across this is V1, and voltage across this is V2, and voltage across V3, this is V3, I'll also have to give a direction in voltages. Suppose I give it like this, one side plus, another side minus. Then I can write this total V, because if you start from here and come to this point, this total V should be equal to sum of these three voltages. And voltage across V1 is defined as I1 R1, voltage across V2 or voltage V2 is defined as I1 R2, current is same, okay, current is same. Similarly V3 is defined as I1 R3, and putting this, I can write this as V is equal to I1 into R1 plus R2 plus R3, okay, or V by I1 is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3, that is equivalence of three resistances which are in series, if you have done in earlier classes. Now the issue is how the voltages are divided. So this, if you see here, basically V1, V2 and V3 is actually total V1, and this V is totally dividing among, sorry, this is 2. This V is dividing among three resistances, V1, V2 and V3. So if I want to calculate V1, this V1 is given by I1 into R1, and that can come out as, if you take this as formula, so this V1 is V1 I1 into R1, and I1 is how much? I1 is V upon, I1 is V upon R1 plus R2 plus R3 into R1. Similarly, V2, you can calculate it as V into R2. So in this case, I can take this as some summation R. It is not same as what we have done in earlier this one. This is R1 plus R2 plus R3. And that depends on how much resistance there is. Accordingly, you get the voltages. Okay, so this V upon R1 plus R2 plus R3 gets weighted by the resistances to give you the voltage across the each of the resistances. So now we'll see a problem having a application of this voltage divider rule. Okay, we'll use voltage divider rule. It is quite common to have this kind of circuits, especially in electronics. So here, if you see, this is voltage and current division. So basically it is voltage division here, and first thing is I am giving you the description of the problem itself. So this description says that it is often required to design a circuit to interface two different systems. Okay, assume that we have a sensor which measures temperature. Okay, so there is a sensor which measures temperature, this one. And the sensor senses the quantity and gives a output in terms of voltage. So this sensor is sensing the heat or whatever it is, and the output is given in terms of voltage. Okay, so measure temperatures and it gives you output in terms of voltage. The output voltage is proportional to the temperature sensed. Obviously, that is why it is sensor. Let us assume that according to the temperature range expected, the range of output voltage is 0 to 5 volts. So this sensor would give from 0 to 5 volts depending on the temperature. Okay, so if the lowest temperature is there, it will show 0, and if the temperature is highest, then it will show 5 volts. The sensed temperature is to be fed to an electronic system which accepts the voltage from 0 to 3.4 volts. So this is an electronic system to which we use for measuring this. We will try to interface. That is what we do with sensors. So if you want to interface this, now this has a problem that it can take only between 0 to 3 volts. Okay, normally 3.3 volts is there, but let us make it simple. So 0 volt to 3 volt is accepted, and beyond that it may damage. Okay, so you cannot supply anything beyond 3 volts, and the range for this is 0 to 5 volts. Now there is also a limitation on the sensor that it cannot supply current more than 20 milliamperes. So you cannot, the sensor will have certain limitation. You cannot have more than 20 milliamperes, and if you want to have more than that, it gets damaged or the measurements become erroneous. The electronic circuit can be considered as a resistance equivalent of 10 mega ohms. So this electronic circuit to which it is being interfaced, totally we can take it as, equivalently we can take it as 10 mega ohms. And it is assumed that RA by RB, that means if you have this ratio of 1 by 10, then R1 is considered negligible. So it is almost as not there. So now let us try to make this design process. We try to make a voltage divider circuit which will interface these two things together. Okay, what do we mean by interface? So here, if you see, this is equivalent of a sensor which is from 0 to 5 volts. I am showing just by a constant voltage of 5 volts, but it will be varying between 0 to 5 volts depending on temperature. This is your electronic system, 10 mega ohm, that is load resistance, And here I have to make an interface, okay, so that on this side it you get a 3 volts when it is 5 volts on this side, okay. So it is as simple as that. You have to design a voltage divider which is having two resistances, and it divides the voltage here. When it is 5, it will get a 3 volt as a load, okay. So what we do is this, we don't want to make our calculation cumbersome. So what I am trying to do is I am moving this out, assuming that I am going to have R2 at least 1/10, okay. So when it is 1/10, this becomes almost infinite, like a open circuit, okay, using this phenomena, that is RB by R10 greater than 1/10. So if it is 1/10, so if it is 10 ohm mega ohm here, if I take 1 mega ohm this, then this current suffices that this is almost infinite, okay. So now let us try to see this R2 should be, so that is what is written here, this R2 should be less than 1/10 of RL. So that is why let us assume that I have taken it as 1 mega ohm, and also it should work on this ratio, that is R2 by R1, then only I get 3 volts over here. So R2 by R1 should be equal to 3/2, so that total it becomes 5 volts, okay. So that gives me R1 equals to 2/3 mega ohm. Effect of load resistance can be seen. If you want to now see what, if this is my design circuit, that is if you do like this, then you get 2 volt. It is as simple as that, and this is quite practical circuit normally used for in electronics interfacing. You may ask that why you chose 1 mega ohm, why not 10 mega ohm, or maybe 0.5 mega ohms. Yes, you can definitely do it. In a design problem, you have several answers to see the same problem. All you have to make sure that the current which can be supplied, that is 20 mega amperes, is not violated, okay. So when you taking a smaller value, then there is a problem because this may exceed. But if you take a larger value, this problem will never occur because the current will always be going smaller and smaller. But there is a catch in practical sensors. If you have a very small current, suppose I take it as a very small current, okay, allow a very small current, then this sensors and load, the current in this become prone to noise. So if the current is very small, then the problem of noises would be there. So there should be a substantial current so that the noise do not affect. But those are the different things. Here all we have seen that we can take this. Other values are definitely possible. If I take 0.5 mega ohms also, this will get some R2 by R1, which will do the same thing. Okay, so that is the design part. And if you see, let us see what will have happen if I take effect of the load resistance. Okay, so if I say that I have a 5 volt here, so I should get 3 volts over here. Up to this point I should get 3 volts, so that the things are accurate. So 5 volts and 3 volts here. But when I take this as 10 mega ohm, if it was an open circuit, this is perfectly all right. If this is not 10 mega ohms, this is infinite, so this is an open circuit. So you can easily see that this calculates to 3 volts. But when you see, there will be a certain amount of error, okay. If you consider this and you take an equivalent circuit of these two, then you will find that this comes out to be 0.909 mega ohm. So it is not exactly 1 mega ohm, okay, and not exactly 1 mega ohm. So instead of 3 volts, you get something like 2.88, which is close. So if you want more accurate, then you can make it 0.5 or so. But those are different things, so are related to accuracy of the things, okay. So all the thing I wanted to show you in this is how to use voltage dividers for interfacing the what you call interfacing a sensor. So I'll stop here, and rest of the things will be KVL will be coming up in the next part.